Good afternoon, everybody. So I will present you my master thesis and was directed by Raphaël Labérade. So first of all, I will introduce you the context and the motivation of this study. Then I will present the time mapping operators compared in this study. In the third part, I will explain in detail the experimental design and the two experiments carried out for this work. And finally, I will conclude. So first, in introduction, why high dynamic range imaging? So on the left side, you can see a low dynamic range photograph. It means that each pixel can take 256 different values for each color, red, green, and blue. And as you can see, if you look at the picture, you can see that this photograph is overexposed compared to what we can observe in the reality. On the contrary, with an high dynamic range image, each pixel can take more different values, for example, in this table. And so we can get more information about the luminance of the scene, and the image is closest to the reality. Another point about the context of this study is we are trying nowadays to reduce the consumption and find new energy-efficient lighting solutions in building, but while keeping the comfort of occupants. And in order to identify preference of the people, psychovisual tests are carried out. But to avoid tests in real world, we can perform this psychovisual test in virtual environment. However, we have to ensure that the solution preferred in virtual environment are also preferred in real world. So in our laboratory, we are a virtual reality simulator is employed, and it is a low dynamic range device. So the dynamic range of the device is lower than the actual luminance range of the image to be displayed. And so in order image to be displayed, I photograph or synthesize images compute with light simulation programs, which are high dynamic range image. So in order to allow a low dynamic range device to display high dynamic range picture, their dynamic should be compressed with tone mapping operator. So tone mapping operators compress the dynamic range to present image that try to faithfully reproduce the capture scene. But many tone mapping operators are available. So the motivation of this study is the selection of the most suitable tone mapping operator to get an image that most faithfully represents the reality. And for that, psychovisual tests are carried out. And in this study, we want to compare results obtained with three different experimental protocols, and especially results obtained in virtual environment and in real world. So I'm showing you the six tone mapping operator choose to compare in this study. So it is Durand, Fatal, Reinhardt 2002, Ashkimin, Reinhardt 2004, and Drago. And Reinhardt 4 and Drago are global operators. It means that they work uniformly on the image. Each pixel, the process applied on each pixel, the process is applied the same for it to all the pixels. And Durand, Fatal, Reinhardt 2, and Ashkimin are local operators. It means that they adapt the action for each pixel and taking into account its surroundings. So in order to select the most suitable tone mapping operator, we have carried out two experiments with three different experimental protocols, so multi-stimuli rating protocol and multi-stimuli ranking protocol for during the first experiment, and mono-stimuli rating protocol for the second experiment. And we use five different scenes. Three of them were lit by artificial lighting, and two of them with daylighting. Finally, six different tone mapped images were judged for each scene. So how we get the tone mapped image? So first, we photograph the scene with different settings by varying the exposure time and the aperture. So we can get a group of photographs from underexposed to overexposed. And after, we use high dynamic range software to obtain the high dynamic range image from the groups of photographs. And finally, each algorithm of each tone mapping operator is applied on the high dynamic range image to get the 6 different tone mapped image. So as you can see here the classroom judge during the test. So Durand, Reinhardt 4, Drago, Fatal, Ashkimin, and Reinhardt 2. The bathroom. The corridor. The office room with the open blinds, so this room is only lit with with daylighting. And the same room with the closed blinds, only lit with daylighting too. So now I will explain in detail the two experiments conducted and the result obtained. So the first experiment was divided in two steps. First, people were in front of the real-world scene and they have to compare printed images to the real-world scene in front of them with a multi-stimuli rating protocol. Then they were taken in front of the simulator and they observe the same tone-mapped image displayed on the simulator screen and judge with a multi-stimuli ranking protocol. So I will explain. First, so they were in front of the real-world scene and they have to place printed images on a scale from not at all to extremely, and answering to the question, does the image represent the real-world scene? After that, they have to express spontaneous comment on the defect of the two best images identified. After that, in front of the display device, they have to identify from memories of the real-world scene the tone-mapped image most resembled the real-world scene and the one least resembled. So they can freely observe all the images. About the result now. So first, we compute average and standard deviation. And as you can see, Drago and Reinhardt 2 obtain the best average. So the average score are on a scale from 0 to 107. After, we employ the Kruskal-Wallis test and the multiple average comparison test. Four groups appear. Group A represents the most preferred tone mapping operators, and group D is the least one, the least preferred. So Drago and the test result indicate that whatever the scene, the tone mapped image with Drago and Reinhardt 2 are perceptually the closest to the real-world reference with respect to the other tone mapping operators judged here. Ah, okay, so you can see. For the second test, we compute the ratio of the number of times that the tone mapped image for a given tone mapping operator is chosen as the most similar to the reality over the total number of observations. So you can see the two groups appear, and Drago, Reinhardt 2, and Durand get the best result with a ratio over than 88%. And we also employ the multi-average comparison test, and they are in the best class A. Also, look at the number of observations. You can see that Reinhardt 2 and Ashkimin have the bigger number of observations, so the results obtained for both are the most reliable. So then about the defect, the comment. Various categories of defect have been identified. The number of comments for each category are given in this table. As you can see, the darkness of the image and inappropriate color are the most cited defects. And color were inappropriate when participants judge the color too strong or not enough strong, but also too bright, too warm, or on the contrary, too drab. And common color was related to different image features. Participants relate global for the entire scene and local for part of a scene common color defects, linking to light colors and or object colors. So now I will explain in detail the second experiment conducted. So during the second experiment, 50% took part in this experiment, and 42% already took part in the first. So in this time, they were also in front of the real world scene, but they judge each image one after another, and they have to judge each image on a discrete scale, from 1 to 10. And the same, answering to the same question that the image represents the real world scene. So the results are close. We employ the same statistical analysis, and as you can see, Drago and Renard were in the best class A. So now, after that, we want to compare results obtained with the three different experimental protocols. For that, we employ the Kruskal-Wallis test. So first, in this slide, we want to compare results obtained in front of the real-world scene and in front of the simulator screen. If you look at the table of the Kruskal-Wallis test results, you can see that there is no statistically significant difference between results obtained in front of the real-world scene and in virtual environment. So it means that in this work, perceived performance of tone mapping operators do not depend on the reproduction technique, either printed image or displayed on the simulator. After that, we compare the result obtained with both with the two rating protocols. And if you look at the average graph, you can see that average are higher for the second test, but tone mapping operators' ranking order are close for both tests. We also employed the Kruskal-Wallis test, and we found that there is no significant difference between marks obtained by image tone map with Renard 2 for both scenes, and only for the corridor for Drago. So in conclusion, we conducted two experiments and employed three different experimental protocols. So they are described in this table in order to select the most suitable tone mapping operator among six. So as you can see, the evaluation method and the image presentation process were different, but the preferred tone mapping operator are the same, Drago and Renard 2. So, in fact, Drago and Renard 2 are preferred for the tone mapped image with Drago and Renard 2 are judged perceptually the closest to the reality for the five scenes tested in this study and with respect to the other tone mapping operators compared in this study. And this result is obtained with the three different experimental protocols. Moreover, despite the experimental protocol used, the ranking order is kept the same. And the results obtained with the two different reproduction techniques lead to similar findings on the preferred tone mapping operator. So in this work, we found that there is no dependence on the reproduction technique. However, this work relates to the employed camera and its setting and its calibration, but also to all regarding printing, to all regarding the display device, and our results are specific to the five scenes tested. And finally, according to the comment, the most identified defects are the image darkness and the presence of inappropriate colors. So in future work, in order to improve the tone mapped image, it is planned to vary parameters of tone mapping operators. And according to our results, psychovisual tests related to luminance field and lighting configuration preference can be addressed by the display device, the simulator, after an accurate calibration. However, the suitability of the simulator for color application are more uncertain, and further investigation about that are needed. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. I have a first question. You have shot all the five scenes, and then you, according to the different algorithms, you created the tone mapped images.
Yes.
So how do you ensure that there is no bug or no deviation from what the author would have done himself. I mean, how do you ensure that this is really the algorithm of a given author, and that maybe the programmer has not done something which could modify, for example, the darkness of an image or something?
The program of the tone mapping operator, or before?
Before, it means the program from the shot scenes to the tone mapped.
We employ
to the high resolution image, and then from the high resolution, from the high large with the high tonal, with the high dynamicity,
yes,
to the low dynamicity. When you go from high dynamicity to low dynamicity, how do you ensure that you follow exactly the author's algorithm?
I employed already code algorithm.
Okay, so you employed the author's code to do that.
Sorry?
You employed the author's own code to create this,
yes,
low mapped images. Mm-hmm. Okay. Other questions?
Yeah. I assume that you did not do your experiments here in Finland, so weather conditions and daylight may change. So how do you interpret the results that you have for this scene where you see the outside? I mean, the rankings are stable, but I assume that daylight has not been stable.
In fact, for the daylighting room, I create different image. In fact, for one day, I stay in the room and see which step I can take. If people come on the morning, I have picture of the morning, and if people come on the afternoon, on the beginning of the afternoon, they judge the group of photographs of the afternoon, and
okay.
So I made different groups to take into account this.
Okay, question?
Eight-bit imaging has got a bad reputation, but I'd like to try to improve it.
These guys are not over here.
The way
it seems to, I will call them, and then
PCs
here,
is
we
use sRGB or something like that.
Yes.
That's a power function relationship at the back end, so that a code value like 1 over 255, like if you think of it from 0 to 1, actually produces a luminance 1 over 255 to the 2.2. That's 200,000 to 1. So actually, 8-bit imaging delivers a pretty high contrast ratio. Now, you mentioned 8-bit and 16-bit, but it wasn't clear from your presentation whether you were assuming that those coding systems were linear or nonlinear, and also it wasn't clear from your presentation what sort of contrast ratio you were expecting either of the HDR imagery or of the LDR imagery. So I wonder if you have any comments about those issues.
Sorry, I didn't understand the last part of the question.
When people talk about low dynamic range and high dynamic range, some of us old timers with gray hair translate that into contrast ratio.
To contrast?
Issue? Yeah, contrast ratio. Being the ratio of luminance from the brightest white to the darkest dark gray, or some people call it black. But the contrast ratio really dominates what you're calling LDR or HDR, and it has a numerical measurement. So I wonder if you measured those things.
I didn't measure that thing. Just I asked people to express the defect of the images to have some information about the attributes are important on the tone mapped image and are judged for people. From people.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Other questions? So if there are no, yes? There is a question? No. Okay. If there are no other questions, I would like to ask if the next speakers are here. Is somebody from the next group of speakers, Liu, Wan, Sang, Xing, from Wuhan University here? Okay, if they are not here, thank you.
Okay.
Very much.